Yeah.
Oh,
Can I see the picture?
Look at him down there, laughing, talking, having fun. As if there wasn't enough of them around here, being friendly and nice. Gordon has to have a sister show up. Boy, all we need is another friendly person around here. What I should do is give her an old-fashioned grouch welcome and tell her to beat it and scram and never come back here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. Then she won't hang around here. Yeah.
Well, I think I'm gonna...
You going in the house?
Yeah.
I think I'll stay out here for a little while.
Oh, all right. Oh,
okay.
I'll be up a little later.
Okay, see you later.
Okay.
Okay, let's negotiate
this. I say there, I don't believe we've met, huh? Aren't you Gordon's sister?
Yeah, I'm Olivia. Who are you?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm Oscar
the... Oh, the Grouch.
Yeah, you must have heard my reputation. I just want to welcome you to Sesame Street in my own way.
Just a minute. Did I hear you correctly in saying you wanted to welcome me to Sesame Street?
Yeah, well...
Oscar, I've heard about you. I've heard about your reputation,
see?
And I know you're mean and nasty and... downright rude, shall we say?
Yeah.
So I'm not gonna let you welcome me to Sesame Street.
Oh, but...
Because you'll tell me to beat it, or scram, or do something to make me leave. So I just want you to understand that you don't mess with me, and I won't mess with you.
Yeah.
And we'll get along just fine.
Right. Maybe I think I'll like having her around here after all.
Fat.
Cat.
Sat.
Hat. Fat.
Fat.
Fat. Cat.
Cat.
Cat. Sat.
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 Hat.
Hat. Hat.
A fat cat sat on a hat, saw a rat on the mat. Got a bat, had a chat with a gnat that he'd pat in a vat that was flat. Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that.
Small.
Ball.
Tall.
Wall. Small.
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 Ball.
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 Tall.
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 Wall.
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 See the small ball on the tall wall. See it fall in a hall. See it crawl, give it all and call. Hi, y'all. See it call, wear a shawl. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Red.
Head.
Fed.
Red. Red.
Red.
Red. Head.
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 Fed.
Fed. Fed.
Bread.
Bread. Bread.
See the redhead being fed bread on his sled made of lead as he sped to be wet. But he fled instead out ahead up to Ted in his bed. And he said, red head fed bread. Small ball tall wall. Fat cat sat hat. And that's that. Scat!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 o'clock, time to get up. It's a lovely 11 morning. I heard 11 worms yawning. I saw 11 cows sleeping midst the buttercups. I said, how's your cottage cheese? And they said,
I'll dry up.
11. 11 pretty birdies in the trees. Bright yellow beaks and pinky knees. 11 chicks hatching, 11 cats scratching. 11's the number for me. 11 ducklings quacking. 11 pigs lips smacking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11's the number for me, don't you see? 11's the number for me.
Arnie, there you are.
Hi there, Bert.
All this time.
Oh, I've been taking a bath in my tubby there, Bert.
Oh, yeah, I see.
But
yeah.
You know what?
Hmm?
I don't know. There was something that I forgot to do.
Something
and I don't know what
do.
It is, yes.
Oh. Well, I'll try and help you remember.
Well, would you, Bert?
Yeah, let's see. Maybe you just took a bath, so maybe you you forgot to wash behind your ears, right?
Oh, no, Bert. I'm sure I washed behind my ears.
You did. Let's see.
Take a look.
Okay.
Behind this ear?
That's good there. Let's see the other one.
Take a look behind this ear here.
Yeah, that's good too, Ernie. Yeah, you did that.
Yeah, I didn't. I washed behind my ears.
Yeah, let's see. What else could you have forgotten? Hey, you didn't wash your face, right?
Oh, no, I'm sure I washed my face. Take a look at my face, Bert. See how
shiny
clean it is?
Yeah, it's pretty good, Ernie. Mm-hmm. Pretty good. Let's see. What else could you have forgotten? Your hands. You didn't wash your hands, right?
Huh? Oh, no, I washed my hands. See, look how clean they are, Bert. See?
Oh, yeah.
I washed my wrists, too, Bert.
Them, too, huh?
Yeah.
I don't know what you could have... I know, Ernie. You didn't wash your neck. Sometimes we don't wash our necks, but that's okay.
I washed my neck, Bert. Take a look at my neck. See there?
You did, Ernie.
Yeah. Gee, I know Ernie, I washed my neck.
I wonder what you forgot.
I think I know what I forgot, Bert.
I do, too.
I think I forgot to turn off the water, Bert. Oh, no!
Okay, we get it all focused in,
and then...
Oh!
Sorry. Hi!
Yeah, okay, I see
this. Hi, Susan.
Oh, hi,
Olivia.
Hi, Big Bird.
Hey, playing with a camera, huh?
Well, she's giving me a lesson. You know, she's a professional photographer.
Oh, well, I can help, too. Want me to help you?
No, Big Bird. You don't know anything about cameras, do you?
Well, I could turn this little thing on.
Oh, no, don't do that. Big Bird,
you want me to
why
help?
Don't you just move... Just take three steps this way.
How about if I pose?
Just move
this
way right
now.
Not right now. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay.
You wanted to help.
Yeah, that's coming pretty good here, Peter. You got that nut on there now? How's that doing, okay?
Hey! Hi there, Bob.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Here is your birdie helpful friend. I'm here to help.
Oh, thanks very much, Big Bird, but no thanks. I think we can handle it, okay?
Okay, they wouldn't like me to help?
Well, I think we can handle it. Thanks anyway, Big Bird.
You don't want me to help. Oh.
Get that one on
only one to help.
Row and...
Hi, Mr. Pooper.
Pooper.
Hi, Gordon.
Hi, Big Bird.
What you doing?
Well, I'm helping Mr. Hooper with his homework.
Oh, good. Maybe you'd like me to help, too. Right, Mr. Pooper?
Pooper. Do you know anything about science?
Me? Science?
Gordon is helping me with my biology.
Your bio what?
For homework. Biology.
For homework.
Biology.
Yeah, that's a science. And I don't think you can help Mr. Hooper, okay? Please.
But.
You see? Please.
Yeah, this sure.
Slim.
Yeah, well, I'll get out of your way. I only wanted to help, you know. That's all I wanted to do, was to help anybody. I mean, I'm a helpful bird, but I don't get to help because nobody wants me to help.
Say, Big Bird. I wonder if you could help me out.
Help?
Yeah.
You want me to help?
There's another book that I left inside, and I'm going to need it for Mr. Hooper's lesson. Do you think you could get it for me?
Could I? Would I? I told you, I love to help. Oh, boy, I will go help.
I'd really
and where's the book?
It's on the kitchen table. Okay?
On the kitchen table.
Yeah.
I'll go get it. You can count on me.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Okay, that's good. Now we get this break. Oh, hey, Big Bird, I'm glad you're here. I was just about to holler for you. Listen, we need a screwdriver. Could you get one from Louise's Fix-It Shop, please?
A screwdriver?
A screwdriver, yeah.
From Louise's Fix-It Shop?
Yeah, please, we need it right now, okay?
Okay.
Right,
I'll go get it.
But thanks, Big Bird.
Oh, but wait, I said I'd go get the book. Now, let's see, I'll go get the book, and then I can go get
hey,
the
screwdriver.
Get the screwdriver
Big Bird!
First.
Hey, I'm glad you're still here. You know, we're going to need some help after all.
Yeah?
So would you like to pose for us?
Oh,
you're perfect.
Oh, well, I said
model.
I'd be willing to, sure.
A little more to the right, Big Bird.
Look.
Yeah, we want to get the right angle
Big,
for
Big
it.
Big Bird, I need the screwdriver right now. Okay,
oh, yes, yes, yes.
Stand
yes,
still, Big Bird.
What?
Stand
yeah.
still.
Hey,
gotta
Big Bird,
get,
did you get
you
the
gotta
book
get out
yet?
Of focus.
The book, yeah, I didn't get the hey, wait, everybody, help.
What's
wrong? What's wrong?
What is
well,
it?
I said I'd help everybody, but now I need a little help.
What?
Can you help me decide who to help first?
Take you now to Kermit the Frog for another fast-breaking news story.
See, that's my Bob White. Now you want to hear my swallow? And here's the duck. And, hi there! Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News here. And today we're reporting on that nursery rhyme, Old Mother Hubbard. And we're in Old Mother Hubbard's cottage, matter of fact. And you probably remember the nursery rhyme which goes, Old Mother Hubbard went to her cupboard to get her poor dog a bone. But when she got there, the cupboard was bare, and so the poor dog had none. Which doesn't rhyme very well, but that's the way the traditional classic rhyme goes, you see. Oh, matter of fact, here comes Mother Hubbard and her dog now.
Come along, Lamont. There's a good dog. Yes, I bet you're hungry, Lamont. Would you like a bone? Oh, good. Mother Hubbard will go to the cupboard.
Did you see that? Did you see that? Mother Hubbard is indeed going to the cupboard to get her poor dog a bone. And according to all reports, when she gets there, that cupboard is going to be bare.
Oh, my. The cupboard is bare. Mercy. Oh, don't worry, Lamont. Yes, old Mother Hubbard. Oh, now, don't take on so. Oh, there's a good doggy. Yes, Mother Hubbard will find you a bone. I know I have
this,
one.
This may be an exciting new breakthrough, folks. We've never had this happen before.
Oh, here we go. There we are. Okay, Lamont. Oh, my, this is heavy. Here's your stone. Oh, that went right through the floor.
Excuse me, Mother Hubbard. Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News.
And
what you were supposed to do was get your dog a bone, and what you brought him was a stone.
Mm-hmm.
Now, stone and bone both rhyme, but I think the dog really wants a bone because he is indeed hungry.
I don't know what got into me. That's silly. Of course, a bone, Lamont. Yes, old Mother Hubbard will find your bone.
Yes, Mother Hubbard is now going to get a bone. Take it easy, dog. I'm sure she's going to get a bone. Here she comes now.
Oh, talk about your heavy. Okay, Lamont, here's your throne. Look at that. Went right down where the stone went.
Pardon me, Mother Hubbard. Listen, Kermit the Frog here again. What you brought your dog there was a throne. Now, throne also rhymes with bone, just like stone rhymes with bone. But what the dog really wants is a bone, because the dog is very hungry.
Oh, of course. How silly of me. Don't worry, Lamont. I'll be right back. I know just where
Mother
that pesky
is going now to get her dog a bone. Take it easy, Lamont. Yes. I'll bring you a bone in just a minute.
Okay.
Oh, here she comes now.
Lamont, look what Mother Hubbard has for you. A nice red phone.
Pardon me. Excuse me, Mother Hubbard. Listen, what you have here was a you brought a phone. Now, phone also rhymes with bone, as does stone and does throne, but the dog really wants a bone, you see. Ah. All these words
Hello.
Rhyme.
Hello, Wong's Chinese restaurant. Yes, I'd like some egg rolls sent up here and some sweet and sour pork. Would you like to stay for lunch?
How's your Mugu guy pen?
How Marvelous. About a tone? A tone, doggy.
Good, then we're... Yes, then... Fine, we'll have that too.
Frog, I'm returning you to your regularly scheduled program.
Will you please send over enough egg for me on and also some soy sauce? Yeah, yes, well, we... Oh. That's one less. Make that only one egg roll.
Olivia, are you sure you want to take pictures of Oscar?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. He's perfect.
Well, I don't know. I mean, there's so many more better things to take pictures of on Sesame Street. I mean, besides, Oscar wouldn't even let you take his picture. He wouldn't pose for them.
Look, he won't even know I'm doing it. See, I have a few tricks. You just get him up out of the can, and I'll be snapping away. He'll give me thousands of pictures.
Look, I know Oscar, but you're the photographer, if you say so.
Okay.
Hey, Oscar,
come here. Who's banging? Oh, it's you. Gordon, what do you want? Look, why do you have to bang on my can every time you pass here? I mean, look. Can't a grouch be alone? Can't I have some peace and quiet, huh?
Oscar, would you just take it easy?
What?
Olivia just wants to take a few pictures of you, that's all.
What do you mean, take pictures? Hey!
Yeah.
What do you mean, you can't take pictures of me? Look, nobody
Calm
takes
down.
Pictures of this grouch, so just don't worry about... Take that camera away from your eye when I'm talking to you, huh?
Okay, Oscar. I think I got all the pictures I need. Thank you for just being yourself.
You mean you already got the pictures?
Oh, wait, hold on. This would be good, too.
No, hey, wait a minute.
Oh, Gordon. Oscar, that was wonderful. Hey, wonderful.
But, I mean, I have to be standing and smiling to have a picture taken, don't I?
No, you don't. I like the candid shots.
But...
Hey, you know, that's really great, Olivia. Yeah. You picked up a few tricks there in that newspaper
in
Detroit.
You have to be quick. You have to be quick.
Tricks? Yeah. Tricks? I'm the one who's supposed to do tricks around here! Ow.
Brand X.
One, two, three, four, five apples. Five apples take away. One apple leaves four apples. One, two, three, four apples. Four apples take away one apple leaves three apples.
No. Oh.
X. Aha. X-ray.
One, two, three apples. Three apples take away one apple leaves two apples.
X marks the spot.
What say?
I say X marks the spot.
What spot?
This spot. And here's the X that marks it.
One, two. Apples. Two apples take away one apple leaves one apple.
I don't believe you tricked Oscar into letting you take some pictures of
him. Yeah.
I know he was fit to be tied because he hates to have his picture taken.
Well, he was pretty mad, but he was kind of surprised that somebody could trick him.
Look, I want to take some pictures of him. Can we trick him again?
I don't see why not.
Okay, let's...
I mean, you get your camera ready.
Okay.
Get it all set. I'll go over and bang on his can.
Uh-huh.
He'll come up screaming about it.
Oh, everybody's always
banging on my can. And you just snap what?
Oh, that's how you did it?
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Oscar, are you in?
Uh-huh, I knew it was you.
Arthur, come on up. I'd like to talk to you.
Come up? So you can take more pictures of me? What do you think, I was born yesterday?
Oscar, I don't want to take any more pictures of you.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't even have my camera with me.
You expect me to believe that after you tricked me before?
Oscar, it's true. Please come up and talk.
Well, go ahead and talk. I can hear you from here.
But, Oscar, I can't talk to you when you're down there. I have to yell. Come on.
Well, okay. I'll be up in a second.
Okay, I'm waiting.
All right. Here I come.
Okay. Oh, it's so hard. You better take
this. Remember, Oscar's my name. Playing tricks, my game. Oh.
See, that's what you get.
Entrada. Salida.
Okay, Mr. Smiley, we're almost ready to go. I'll give you a countdown in 5 seconds, all right?
You tell me when to start, would
okay,
you?
Okay, ready? Five.
Okay.
Four.
All right.
Three. Mm. Two.
Okay.
One.
Ready. Shall I start now?
Hmm? What?
Shall I start?
Go, 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 go.
Oh, yes, indeed. Okay. Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's me, your favorite star of daytime television guy, Smiley. We have taken our cameras out of the studios and down here to Sesame Street to play your favorite television quiz game, the Anything in the World prize game. Isn't that wonderful? Yeah. Wonderful, wonderful. Okay, now all our contestant has to do is answer all three of our questions, and that contestant can have anything in the world. How about that? All right, so let's welcome our first contestant, Mr. Oscar Grouch.
Look. I was just in the middle of a manicure here,
mm-hmm.
And...
Yes?
Hey, what's all this?
Well, these are cameras, Mr. Grouch, and as you well know, I'm Guy Smiley, star of daytime television, and this is the Anything in the World prize game! Yeah.
Hi, Mr. Smiley! Hi!
Look, peddle it somewhere else. I never watch television.
Well, all you have to do... all you have to do to win anything in the world that you want is to answer our three questions. Are you ready?
Look, probably you didn't understand. You can take those questions.
Well, now here is your first question, Mr. Grouch. And lucky you, this first question is an easy one. Are you ready? What is my name?
Who is this guy?
Who is this guy? Right, guys! Wonderful, that's one question. Wonderful, that's one question right, and two to go. Here is your next question. Can you give me a two-letter word beginning with the letter N? That means the opposite of yes.
No. No.
Right? No. Wonderful. That's a two-letter word beginning with the letter N, and it's the opposite of yes. That's two correct answers, and one more will make three. And we all know what that means, don't we, folks? Yes. It means anything in the world. Okay. All right, now, no help. No help from the audience, please. Here is the third and last question. Now, listen carefully. What will happen to the man who goes into the woods without a map?
Get lost.
Get lost.
What will happen to the man who goes into the woods without a map? And the correct answer is get lost! Yeah! Wonderful! You have won anything in the world! The next word that you speak will affect the rest of your life. Now that you can choose anything in the world that you want, what will it be?
Get out of here! Get out of here!
Get out of here! Did you hear that, folks? It's an unusual but interesting request. This is Guy Smiley, star of daytime television, wrapping it up for today and saying so long for the Anything in the World prize game.
I have a feeling that I blew an opportunity there somehow.
Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye, everybody. Let's wrap it up, Ernie. I think we got off easy on that one.
Living out in the open, all by himself, in the wind and the rain, nobody to keep him company, except maybe and meanwhile, old Buddy Burt would be up at the North Pole, living in an igloo, surrounded by endless snow and ice, all alone in the world, except for a fish. I can imagine that. Years and years would go by. Ernie would get gray and bent and stooped over. And he'd grow a long white beard. And Bert would lose his hair. And he'd grow a beard too. And they'd both grow very, very old. And they'd never, never, never see or talk to each other again.
Yep, I sure can't imagine that.
We'd never see each other again?
Never, 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 never.
Well, that's a little longer than I had figured on, actually.
Yeah, me too. Well, Ernie.
Yes, Bert.
Ernie, maybe that was your cookie after all.
Bert.
What?
I'm sorry I ate that cookie.
Well, I guess I'm sorry I poked you in the tummy, Ernie.
Oh, Bert, just for the record, Bert, it was my cookie that I ate.
But Ernie, how can you be sure?
Because I ate your cookie this morning, Bert.
I figures.
But I'm sorry I ate your cookie, Bert.
Let's go home, okay? Thanks, Maria.
Well, that's much better, right?
We'll see you, Maria.
Bye-bye.
This is my pet letter Y. Her name is Yetta. I feed her yogurt and yams. These are foods that begin with the letter Y. Yetta thinks they're yummy. Yesterday, I fed her a yo-yo. I thought she liked the yo-yo because it also begins with the letter Y. She didn't. Hey, when I do that, I yell. Now, dogs don't yell. When he does that, he yelps. People yell, dogs yelp. Now, yodel hee hoo, people yodel in. Dogs yowl, but we do some things alike. We both we both yawn, so we do have something in common, right?
Yep.
Thank you.
Ernie.
Yes, Bert.
No, Ernie. What? Ernie, what are you doing with those cookies in bed, huh?
Well, the cookies, well, I was just hungry, Bert, so I thought I'd have a few cookies before I went to sleep.
Ernie, don't eat those cookies while you're in your bed, huh?
Why not, Bert?
Because you get crumbs in the sheets, that's why.
Gee, Bert, I get crumbs in the sheets?
Yeah, Ernie, and if there are crumbs in the sheets, they'll get in your pajamas.
Ooh, crumbs in my pajamas, Bert?
Yeah, Ernie, and if you get crumbs in your pajamas, they'll make you itch. You know
oh,
that.
I don't like to itch, Bert.
No, and if you itch, you won't be able to sleep, Ernie, so don't do it, okay? Good night.
Oh, gee. If I eat the cookies in bed, I'll get crumbs in my sheets. And if I get crumbs in the sheets, I'll get crumbs in my pajamas. And if I get crumbs in my pajamas, I'll itch, and I won't be able to sleep. Oh, Bert, thank you so much for stopping me from eating cookies in my bed.
All right, Ernie, just go to bed, okay?
Okay. And I'm never going to eat cookies in my bed again.
Okay, good. Ernie, what are you doing?
I'm going to eat cookies in your bed, Bert. Move over.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. 11 o'clock, time to get up. It's a lovely 11 morning. I heard 11 worms yawning. I saw 11 cows sleeping bits. The buttercups, I said, how's your cottage cheese? And they said,
ah, dry up.
11 pretty birdies in the trees. Bright yellow beaks and pinky knees. 11 chicks hatching, 11 cats scratching. 11's the number for me. 11 ducklings quacking. 11 pigs lip smacking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11's the number for me, don't you see? 11's the number for me.
Hey, kids, why don't we go down to the park to play our game? You know where all the trees are? Because we're going to play a game something like hide and seek. Except it's called Ring Olivia. Oh, there's Olivia. Hey, Olivia, you want to come and play with us kids in the park?
Oh, no thanks, Big Bird, not today.
What's the matter? You look kind of sad.
Well, I don't want to go into it. I'll talk to you about it later.
Hey, listen, kids, I got a plan.
Oh, hey, Olivia.
Hey, Bob.
Hey, you look kind of down. What's happening?
Oh, I don't want to talk about it. You're busy, and I don't want to bother.
No, I'm not that busy. Besides, I'm not going to let you go in and get yourself more upset. What's wrong? Why don't we go over to Mr. Hooper's and talk about it, okay?
Okay, I'm sure you don't mind.
Of course I don't mind. I just like to make you feel better. What's wrong?
Oh, I just went out looking for a job today, and...
Hello, Bob, Olivia. Hi, Mr. Hooper. How you doing?
What can I get you?
A job.
A what?
Yes.
Oh.
I was out job hunting today, and nothing. All these crossed-off places told me no.
I'm sorry, but I can't help you that way. But how would some fresh lemonade sound?
Oh, I think that would hit the spot.
That's good.
Really? Good. Coming right up. I just made it.
Good.
You went to all these people today?
Yes.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, it's amazing, all right. None of them had any job openings. They wouldn't even look at my picture.
Really?
Yeah,
it's pretty rough getting a job these days, but I'm sure you'll find one. It'll probably just kind of take a while, you know?
Yeah, but I went to so many places.
Yeah, but, you know, don't forget, you're a really, really good photographer, you know? So I'm sure something will turn up.
Here we are.
Oh, that's terrific.
Oh, wonderful.
Hey, great.
Wonderful.
This is what we needed.
Thank
good.
You.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Toast.
Cheers.
Olivier.
This is
a job.
For a job tomorrow, okay?
Oh, okay. We're going to get one.
Right. Good.
Good, good.
Hey.
Come on, kids.
Hey, that hit the spot.
Come on.
Hi, Big Bird.
Oh,
hi.
Look what's here.
Olivia.
Oh.
Come on, kids.
Friend?
Well,
what's all this?
Olivia wasn't feeling good, and us kids noticed it, so we went and did some drawings for you to cheer you up.
Oh, look at this.
Show them to her.
Nice.
Oh, those are great. Look.
Yeah.
Look at that one. Hey, that's
nice. Oh, they're so colorful.
You look at them. Oh,
Mercy, that's and look at that. Nice. I did one of me for you.
Hey, that's terrific, Big Bird. You really
know, I know why Susan and Gordon really like around here. You guys are great.
Not a bad word.
No.
I'll drink to that.
Oh.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters X and Y and by the number 11.
Sesame Street is the production of the Children's Television Workshop.